On the used market, an older smart speaker from Sonos can be had for a song at this point. And so they are becoming a really interesting opportunity for you, especially if you have Samsung SmartThings in your home, to create all kinds of different automation capabilities and get a lot out of a connected speaker. Hello automators, thanks for tuning in again. I'm Brian from Automate Your Life, and today I'm going to take the frustration out of automation by giving you a whole new option with the Sonos speakers you either already have in your smart home or giving you an option for maybe going out and getting a new connected smart speaker and doing something really different. Because right now it can be very difficult to create audible notifications of events in your smart home. We've seen Amazon do a little bit of this with some of their devices and some of their routines. Google really still can't do a lot of this, and so your smart speakers can actually be really difficult to integrate with automation. But especially if you have this SmartThings hub over here, or the SmartThings platform in general, even without the hub, you can start to create notifications for things like people arriving or automation events within your smart home, or you can cause music to be playing at different times throughout your home or based on different events. So let me show you how to do a lot of this. Let's start with the type of speaker that you're going to need. Now, this is a Play One, so this is more than a couple of years old at this point, and that means basically anything up from there, all the new speakers are going to have this capability for integration within the SmartThings platform. Now, I'm going to assume that you've already set up your Sonos speaker. I'm not going to show you the base setup. I actually have a very old video for doing that and how it's calibrated and how it's set up, but once you've done that and it's in the Sonos application, you now have a very easy way within the new SmartThings app to go ahead and add in this speaker. So let me show you how to do that very quickly. So you're going to go to add a new device as per usual, as you would within the SmartThings application, and then you're going to search for Sonos. Once you do that, you're going to pick speaker, and you can go ahead and find your exact speaker at that point. Once it's found the device, you're going to add it as you would any other device, and you can place it in a room and rename the speaker within SmartThings platform. Now that you have your Sonos speaker in the application, you actually get a whole new interface. So you can scroll through the home page and you will actually find your Sonos speaker, or maybe multiple Sonos speakers. They come in groups or as individual speakers. So you can actually just in the top right hit the play button and it will start. So that's a quick interface, but you can go into the speaker itself, you can change the volume very quickly, and then you can also choose any of your favorites. And this is maybe the big thing you want to do inside the Sonos application, is get your favorites or your My Sonos list, that's what it's called today, all set up, and then you can pick from any of those favorites through this basic interface. Now you can also edit the device name, and you can change the room it's in, you can delete the device if you're not happy with the integration for any reason in the future, so it's not stuck here, and then you can see the activity history within the device. Now that you have that basic interface down, let's go deeper, let's have a little more fun with this. So you can go into the automation section of the application, and you can actually create an automation with this speaker, and you can use it on the if side of any automation, or you can use it on the then side of any automation. So within the if side, you have media playback, and you can trigger when this starts to play or stops playing or pauses, you can actually trigger other automations. You can go ahead and use the mute side, group volume, and you can actually have it match a certain volume level, or you can say equal or below or equal or above a certain level. And you can do the same thing with a group, so you can mute the whole group. So those are your triggers. On the then side of integration, you can actually choose a lot of different things, and you can choose media playback, but you can't choose the specific song or the specific favorite that it's going to start. It's whatever's kind of queued up on the device. So you can cause it to trigger to play. You can also cause it to go next and previous. So if you actually want to create automations like with things like buttons where you're just pressing the button, and I'm doing this in a number of different ways already, you can go ahead and go to the next song. You can change volumes. You can change the mute and all of that, and you can do it by group. Now, one of the most powerful things is actually the delay this action, and you can customize exactly how long you want to delay that action, but really what it allows you to do is something as simple as when you return home, delay a little bit. So once your phone has been recognized, delay a little bit and have this speaker start playing so that you walk into the space and the music is really just starting for you.
Hello, Brian. Welcome home.
Hello, Brian. Welcome home.
One of the most powerful things that you can do is the notification capability. So you can get this device to say all kinds of things based on what's going on in your home. And this is inside of the Smart App section. Now, what you will find is every one you create creates a new one. So you can see the notification of arrival and the notification of leak. That's what I've called these things. And what they are doing is they are notifying me through this speaker what is going on. So the notification is SmartThings detected a flood on this speaker. You could pick the groups or you could pick the individual speaker. The water sensor is my basis, and you can see I've chosen all of my different water sensors. And do I want to resume music currently right after the notification has occurred? Yes. Do I want a specific mode? And then there's the name. Now I'll show you every one of these that you set up is a brand new one. So you hit the plus and you add a smart app. Now what this is called is the speaker companion, and this will be there all the time. You can go ahead and have that happen at any time. Now you can have the control of music basically, so you can play, stop, pause, or skip. You can play those custom notifications, and that's what we're gonna go through. Or you can play a weather report, and that's based on the location you have set inside of Samsung SmartThings. So I've gone into notification here, and I'm going to choose custom message. You can choose any of these other ones, and you saw my leak detection one said SmartThings detected a flood. That's great, that's easy, that's what will come out of this device. But you can choose a custom message, and then you will actually get to type in what the message is. So I'm going to type in hello automators. I'm going to choose my office Sonos, and that's where it sits in my home. And then basically I'm going to choose what the thing that I need to have happen is. So I'm going to choose the button, and you can see that it's just the pressed, so it's not allowing me to choose the double tap or the hold on this button. I could choose any of the modes, so I'm going to choose all of them, and then I'm going to assign a name. I hit done, and this is a new smart app inside. So you can see button press notification. So now that I've set that up inside the SmartThings application, it is as simple as pressing this button, that's what I've set up, to have a notification come out. So let's try it.
Hello, automator.
So you can see a bit of a delay there. That's probably my whole home network or a bunch of things going on there. But this button did manage to trigger that whole thing to go on. Now I just want to show you quickly all the different things that you can trigger off of here. So motion, contact sensors or multi-purpose sensors, acceleration. So if you have that vibration or the motion detection capability on those multi-purpose sensors, those are there. The switches on and off, arrival, departure, so you can use your phone or the arrival sensors, the water sensors, which we already talked about, button presses, and even changing modes. So you could set specific modes where you wanted notifications to come out of this device for, and then at certain scheduled times, you can have this just trigger to remind you to do something. Now let's go another level deeper, and that's how I usually like to run these kind of tutorial videos, is go a little bit deeper. Now if there's something specific you're looking for, go ahead, leave that down in the comments below right now. I want that interaction between us, and I always help people as much as I can within the comments section. Now the other thing that I think you're going to ask about is, can I integrate with X, or can I do a more complicated scenario than just this simple one device trigger? And the answer to that is yes, you absolutely can, but this is going to take virtual switches, and virtual switches will give you the ability to use if this and that to trigger on and off those virtual switches if you'd like. And you can also use those virtual switches to create a more custom automation. So let's go much deeper here. I'm going to run you through a full tutorial of how virtual switches can get set up. And then I'm going to show you how you can apply this in your smart home to a much more complicated situation. The first thing you're going to need is the Samsung SmartThings Classic application, and this is going to be a short timeline that you need this, but this is how you can create your first virtual switch in the Samsung SmartThings system. And then once you do that, you can go back to the SmartThings application and create new virtual switches going forward.
So you can see I could choose a switch or a dimmer switch, and then you can go ahead and name the device whatever you want. It becomes a physical device in the application. Now, once you switch over to that existing SmartThings application, you will now find the virtual device creator sitting there, and you can add a new one simply by choosing which type of switch you would like, and then you choose the name and hit done, and this will create another one for you if you ever need another virtual switch. Now let's go ahead and create the new smart app, the speaker companion smart app that is going to be based off of the virtual switch that we just created. Now I'm going to choose to play a notification and then the custom message that we've used earlier in the video. I'll type in a new custom message and then choose the speaker that I'm going to play this on. And our trigger event is going to be the switch that we just created, that virtual switch. So I'm going to scroll down and find my virtual switch. Now I could do any of the other things that we talked about, but really I'm just going to pick a name and hit done.
Now that you've created that virtual switch, what we're going to use that virtual switch is for the trigger event for our overall speaker companion notification. In this example specifically, I'm going to say that someone is at home as one of my if conditions, and it's within a certain period of time. Plus, they have turned on one of my plugs or lights, and you could pick whatever device you'd like. This is three conditions and clearly not what you're able to do with just the basic speaker companion. So this is going much deeper. The then side of the automation will be to turn on that virtual switch. And I will also choose to auto turn off that device. That you could choose any timeline you'd like with that, but that's what I'm going to choose here. And I'm just going to choose to turn it off after a minute. This will mean that your conditions can continue to occur time and time again. So you have to think about when you want to do that. You might set up a whole separate automation for, say, at the end of the day, just to turn off that virtual switch again, and then that will ensure that it only happens once per day. Now that we have that virtual switch coming on the exact condition that we want, our automation system will actually trigger all the way to this speaker playing that custom notification. Now, of course, you might have a certain specific condition that you'd like with Samsung SmartThings, and I know how complex these things can be. So go ahead, leave that down below. Otherwise, you might want to watch our full walkthrough of the new Samsung SmartThings application. Not a lot of people are ready for that application, and so you might need some help navigating. That's a full walkthrough. It's indexed so you can have a look at what you exactly want to watch within that application. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching today. And of course, don't hate, automate.